The custom movement behavior can be used to implement alternate movement styles not available using the other movement behaviors, like platform, 8 direction, and car. Let's take a look at how the custom movement behavior works. In Construct 2, there are lots of built-in behaviors that handle the movement of objects. The platform behavior, for example, allows your object to run, jump, fall, etc. Normally, this is enough, and you should use these behaviors whenever possible. But there are occasions where you may need to implement a custom movement style that doesn't fall under any of these predefined behaviors. In that case, you want to use the custom movement behavior. With other behaviors, the object is moved using the object's speed along the x-axis and y-axis, represented by its dx and dy. If an object is moving towards the right of the screen at 50 pixels per second, its dx, or x speed, is 50. Instead of automatically implementing the movement using the object's dx and dy, the custom movement behavior stores these values for you and allows you to use them to move the object yourself in the event sheet. The way the custom movement behavior works is by updating the object's position every tick, determined by its dx and dy values. Each time it updates the object's position, it's called a step. Each step's length is determined by the object's pixels per step property. If the object is traveling further than the value in pixels per step, it will make more than one step per tick. One of the reasons why custom movement can be so useful is that the collision detection works on each step, whereas with other behaviors, it works on each tick. Let's take a look at why this matters. I've got this line added to the layout to demonstrate the issue. If I speed up, you can see the ship and the line overlapping as the ship crosses over. If this line were a solid, a collision would occur, just like we would expect. But watch what happens as I keep speeding up. As the ship really begins to speed up, you start to see multiple ships. There's still only one ship object, but it's moving so fast you're not seeing it as a smooth animation. You're seeing it get rendered that many pixels ahead of where it was last rendered. At this point, the ship is flying through the line, and it's basically teleporting past it. If this line were a solid, a collision would no longer occur, since the ship is jumping right over the line. By using the custom movement behavior, you can move in steps. That means every tick, the object will make multiple movements, checking for collision at each step of the way. Now, it's important to remember that visually this will look the same, but behind the scenes in the collision detection, you'll be able to prevent the object from teleporting over another object. The custom movement behavior has two properties, stepping mode and pixels per step. Stepping mode determines how the object will step each tick. If stepping mode is set to none, the object will step once per tick, and the pixels per step property won't be used. Linear will step the object directly towards its destination in a straight line. Horizontal then vertical will cause the object to step once on the x-axis and then once on the y-axis, and then repeat until it reaches its destination. Vertical then horizontal is just the opposite. It will step once along the y-axis and then once along the x-axis. Remember, it will check for collision on each of these steps, so you can get better, more fine collision detection by doing this. Pixels per step determines how long each step will be. So let's say you're moving 50 pixels per tick, and pixels per step is set to 5. If stepping mode is set to linear, in that one tick, the object will make 10 steps towards its destination, each step consisting of 5 pixels. The custom movement behavior is one of the more advanced behaviors available, and you should only use it if you actually need to get additional functionality out of your controls. If the platform behavior works, use it. But if you find that you need greater control, and none of the other behaviors are working for you, or you just need that added level of collision detection accuracy, then you should use the custom movement behavior. It can be very useful, but should only be used when absolutely necessary.